සුබෝදෑසනක් good morning මම රමල් ජාසිංහ මම නියෝජනය කරන්නේ ජාතික අපනයන මණ්ඩලයේ සභාපති හැටියට භූමි සුදී මාව මේ කොමිසමට කැඳවගත්තට අපේ අදහස් පැහැදිලි කරන්න ප්‍රකාශ කරන්න මොකද මගේ මම නියෝජනය කරන්නේ අපේ සමාජිකයින් ඒ කරන්න ඉස්සෙල්ල මට කැමති ළඟදී නිකුත් කරපු මහා බැංකුවේ වාර්ෂික වාර්තාව ගැන පොඩි විග්‍රහයක් තියෙනවා. ඒක හැබැයි මට ඕලන්ට බෙදා අරින්න දැන් අවසරයක් නැහැ. මොකද මේක අර කරලා තියෙන්නේ මේ රිසර්ච් කම්පැනි එකකින්. ඉතින් ඒකෙන් දැනට ඇවිල්ලා තියෙන තත්ත්වය තමයි මම ඉංග්‍රීසියෙන් කියවන්නම්. increasing chinese presence. ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් අද තත්ත්ව හැටියට චීනය ඉන්දියාවට වඩා වැඩි අපනයන ප්‍රමාණයක් දැනට ඇවිල්ලා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් අපේ ට්‍රේඩ් බැලන්ස් එක තව දුරටත් වැඩි වෙලා තියෙනවා චීනයත් එක්ක. එතකොට ස්ටැග්නන්ට් per capita income. ඒ කියන්නේ අපේ දළ නිෂ්පාදනයේ දියුණුවක් වෙලා නැහැ. ඒක තාම US ඩොලර් 3000කින් මේ ගිය අවුරුදු 3ටම දියුණුවක් වෙලා නැහැ දළ නිෂ්පාදනයේ. I am quoting from the report given, a research report given on the examination of the annual report of the central bank. This is done by Frontier Research, but it's a confidential thing given to my company. Last year, the 2016 one, this is their analysis. So they had taken 5 points from that. So I will read out the 5 points. On the report. So what they have found, I will only present their findings here, I will read it out, right? The key takeaways, right? So increasing Chinese presence, that is China replaced India as the biggest import source of Sri Lanka in 2016. Sri Lanka's trade deficit with China increased significantly over the past 5 years. Tourist arrivals from China grew tenfold since 2012. Then the stagnant GDP, per capita GDP, has remained largely stagnant for the last 3 years despite demand conditions in the economy and changing considerably during this period. So we haven't had a significant improvement in the GDP. Right? Then FDIs have been better than expected in 2016, although they are less than 2015. So there have been a slight improvement in 2016 over the last quarter on the FDIs. Foreign direct investments have been a slight improvement, but it's less than 2015. Then with regard to credit, private credit, the construction industry has driven the credit growth in the banking system. Ekenne bank of paddhatiye naya wadiyama aran tiyenne indigirime karmaante. So that looks like the developing industry, and there have been improvements on the fiscal front according to this report, right? So total government revenue excluding grants as a percentage of GDP was at 14.2% in 2016, the highest recorded since 2009. Total revenue grew by 16% compared to 2015. The growth was mainly driven by a significant increase in non-tax revenue, which more than doubled during the year, and this was owing to the increase in profit and dividend transfers from state-owned enterprises. Right. So tax revenue. They haven't given details on that. They haven't given details, they have stated it. So in the detailed report, they would have shown that. So the growth is mainly driven by, then tax revenue as a percentage of GDP remained unchanged. Right? Increases in VAT and import related tax revenue was partly offset by the decline in revenue from excise duty on motor vehicles, corporate and non-corporate income taxes and withholding tax. So what they conclude is, then what they talk about the views on the Sri Lankan rupee rates and the base case, right? Now, I will quote straight, I read out. Our base case view sees a decline in interest rates and a possibility of a further limited depreciation in the Sri Lankan rupee against the US dollar by the end of 2017. So our base case of 45% probability expects a 12-month T-bill rate to decline at the end of 2017 between 7.5% and 10%, as at 2nd May 2017, which is at 10.63%. Then our base case for Lankan rupees again with a 45% probability sees the currency depreciating a bit further with an upper bound limit of 158 rupees against the US dollar, which is now above the low end of 148 as per base case view. So 2nd May it was 151 against the USD. So we can see a depreciation of the rupee by the end of the year. So this is the backdrop. So within this backdrop, what the chamber's view, there are 10 points here that I have put in summary, right? So before I get to this, I would like to point out that we welcome these trade arrangements provided there are opportunities and that our interests are met. So the interests of our entrepreneurs, our manufacturers and also employees, and the transfer of knowledge. And more so, we must have the same advantages that we get, particularly on non-tariff barriers in those markets. Because we find particularly in territories like India, we are encountered with a lot of non-tariff barriers. And also, let me read these points out and then I'll hand this over. Right? Now, these are summaries that we have written to the Director General of trade, we have written to the Secretary, Minister of Development Strategy and International Trade, Mrs. Vijayawardena, and we have given details, right? So those headings are on the investment policy, what we should have in terms of a strategy. Then the export policy, trade agreements, trade facilitation, policy and institutional coherence, and the general comments. So those are the points we had done in detail, and I have summarized those into bullet points here, which I will read out to you. No, this is the interpretation from an agency called Frontier Research. Now, this has been given to the place I work in, so that's why, therefore, I'm restricted in sharing it in public. But these are the insights which I thought was very useful to set the pace for this discussion.
Is it available in the internet?
I don't think so. It's not in public domain. I can't. Otherwise, I would have had no hesitation to give, but what I can do, I can show on TV some of the charts, right? So they are the top three charts. Now I don't know whether this is clear enough. Right? Now this chart says China surpassed India as the main import origin of Sri Lanka in 2016. Value of imports from China increased by twofold. That's about US dollars 2 billion since 2011.
Our imports
to China, from China. So our trade imbalance has expanded. So when you see this part, when you compare 2016, imports from India had dropped against imports of China.
But India also, the deficit remains very
the same. Yeah, okay, the deficit has dropped quite significantly if you look from 2015 to 2016. Now what is in blue is in the Indian key, right? So this has dropped fairly significantly. So what they attribute that is to petroleum and products and motor vehicles, where imports due to levies would have had an impact. Right? Then the other is per capita GDP remained largely unchanged for these 3 years. They are taking the central bank report.
Latest
report. What was released last week. Now this is a brand new report. I don't think anybody else has. This is
central bank report. We can get it.
Yeah, so this is central bank. This is their interpretation of the key points from the central bank report. Yeah. Okay. So I thought why I brought this up was because the significance of the rupee depreciation, which could be an advantage to our exporters if we exploit it. And also the... we are trying to see whether we can exploit it, right? So by bringing up the... So that's why it comes to the where these FTAs and I mean going into the FTAs without thinking too deeply. Yeah. So we have been keeping it afloat, right? I mean they are devices, right? That's right, so that's why so you are doing other gimmicks, right, to keep it up. So there have been ups and downs. So point is this, one of the fundamental things, we see that our exports are not diversified. Now we had to go on a diversification of our exports and our services. Now that hasn't happened enough. And I think that is one of the main things we need to address. It has to be developed. We have to develop it. So it is on that backdrop that we have written to the Secretary of the Ministry. Right? So, exactly. Non-tariff barriers. Now it is like this, you might be able, you will sign FTA with India for example, but in Chennai, due to their state regulations, you may not be able to market there. So on the surface it looks very easy, but then when you go into the in-depth, we have a non-tariff barrier, and then the state has their own taxes and other ways of addressing or giving a making our exports more difficult. So, right. So the summary of the important points of our representations are the need for the core issues and suggested policies to be highlighted in the policy document to attract the attention of decision makers and to be a marketable document among the relevant stakeholders of the public. Now what we feel is that for one thing is there is not enough public awareness on what we are getting into and what the implications are. And also if we are doing that, it should be a document that everybody will understand, the public at large. Then the poor export performance of Sri Lanka is due to the lack of diversity of products and services. Is primarily due to the inadequacy of production capacities and cost competitiveness. So we have internal barriers that we have to surmount. So as such, the importance of capacity creation through foreign direct investments with necessary investments and incentives through a clear investment policy, which should be part and parcel of the trade policy. I think we get back to the ease of doing business and the ease of entrepreneurs performing. Then the third point is the need to clarify as to how the trade policy will be integrated with the export policy. As in the case of the investment policy, with clear guidelines and directions related to skills development to overcome the shortage of identified technical and management skills. Right now we see an issue in the construction industry, I think, where we are getting labor also imported. Then innovative mechanisms to finance investments and R&D activities. Because we feel R&D is not being performed effectively enough. And identification of new sectors with potential for development. Now it is in this backdrop that the chamber has is proceeding on a path of developing an export entrepreneur. So we are going to the provinces, provincial chambers, and we are trying to link up say outgrowers or manufacturers, say if it is handicrafts, handicrafts to a exporter or to get them those markets. So we are looking at the SMEs, Kudasa Madhyama Parimane, Karmant, Adagana, Eva, Atadila, Kumada Apanayana, Velandapalata, Andunwa Denne Gela. එහෙම අපි ටාගට් කරලා නැහැ. හැබැයි මොකද මෙහෙම අයිදන් අපි නියෝජනය කරන්නේ බහු කර්මාන්ත. ඒකන්දෙන් අර ඇපරල් ඉන්නවා, රබ ප්‍රඩක්ස් ඉන්නවා, ෆුඩ් ප්‍රඩක්ස් තියෙනවා, ඇග්‍රිකල්ච ප්‍රඩක්ස් තියෙනවා, ෆ්ලෝරල් ප්‍රඩක්ස් තියෙනවා, ඒ වගේ. ඉතින් අපි හැබැයි මෙහෙම එකක් තියෙනවා. ඉතින් SME හැබැයි අපි මෙහෙම දෙයක් කියලා මම කලින් කිව්වා වගේම අපේ ප්‍රාදේශීය මණ්ඩල තියෙනවා. වෙළඳ සංගම්, වෙළඳ මණ්ඩල, අපි ඒගොල්ලන් එක්ක සමීපයක් හදාගෙන ඒගොල්ලන්ගේ සමාජිකයන්ට හරියන ක්‍රමයකට අපි ඒ කනෙක්ෂන් එක දෙනවා. ඉතින් මෙහෙම ඉතින් අපි කියන්නේ එක පියවරක් ගන්න ඕනේ. අපි දැන් මේ ගන්නෙ මේ පළවෙනි පියවරේ. ඉතින් ඒකට ඉතින් අපිට EDB එකත් අවශ්‍යයි. අපිට තනියම මේක කරන්න බෑ. මොකද අපි ඇවිල්ලා ප්‍රයිවට් සෙක්ටර් එකේ මණ්ඩලයක්. ඉතින් අපිට පාර කපලා දෙන්න හදලා දෙන්න පුළුවන්. ඉතින් ඊට එහෙන් ඉතින් අපි ඒක ගෙනියන්න ඕනේ. ඒ කියන්නේ මෙහෙම එක්ස්පෝර්ට් ඔන්ටර්ප්‍රනර් කෙනෙක් හදන්න තමයි අපේ අදහස. හරි. ඒකට තමයි අපි දැන් මම සහභාගී වෙනවා අපේ දැන් EDB එක හරහා ට්‍රේඩ් පොලිසි එකක් දැන් ගොඩනගාගෙන යනවා. එතකොට බ්‍රෑන්ඩින් එකක්. දැන් බ්‍රෑන්ඩින් එකේ කලින් ශ්‍රී ලංකාව මොකද්ද? ටී වලට කියනවා සිලොන් ටී කියලා, අනිත් ඒවාට මේඩ් ඉන් ශ්‍රී ලංකා කියලා කියනවා. හැබැයි මම මෙහෙම අඩුවක් දැක්කා. මොකද මම මේ EDB එකට මම යෝජනා කරා, ඊට පස්සේ ඒක ක්‍රියාත්මක කරා. දැන් අපේ අලෙ මේක ඇවිල්ලා තියෙන කියන්නේ බ්‍රෑන්ඩින් කියන්නේ අලෙවිකරණයක්. ඉතින් ඒ අලෙවිකරණයට මමත් අලෙවිකරණ පුත්තිකෙක්. ඒ හැටියට මම යෝජනා කරා ශ්‍රී ජයවනදපුර විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයයි, කැලණිය විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයයි, ශ්‍රී ලංකා මාකටිං ස්ලිම් එකත් එක්කව කරන්න කියලා. මොකද ඊට කලින් අපි ඒ වගේ ප්‍රාත්මයකට අපි කියන්නේ ඇකඩමියා එක නැත්තම් මේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයයි මේ පුත්තිකයන් අපි එක සම්බන්ධ කරලා නැහැ. කලින් වෙලා තියෙන්නේ යම් කෙසේ කියන්නේ EDB එකේ හරි කොහෙන් මේ ඒ වගේ මණ්ඩලයක් හරහා අපි මාකටිං එෆර්ට් එකක් කරන්න හදනවා, බ්‍රෑන්ඩින් එෆර්ට් එකක් කරන්න හදනවා. හැබැයි ඒකේ තියෙන ස්ටේක් හෝල්ඩර්ස්ලා අපි එක්කව කළා නැහැ. ඉතින් දැනට මට සතුටුයි කියන්න අපි කතා කරන ගමන් කොන්සෙප්ට් පේපර් එකක් දීලා තියෙනවා බ්‍රෑන්ඩින් ශ්‍රී ලංකා කියලා. ඒකට සහභාගී වෙලා තියෙනවා මේ ડોક્ટર රවි දිසානායක මේ කැලණිය මේ විශ්වවිද්‍යාලයෙන්. එතකොට ජාදනපුර විශ්වවිද්‍යාලෙනුයි ශ්‍රී ලංකා ඉන්ස්ටිටියුට් ශ්‍රී ලංකා ඉන්ස්ටිටියුට් මාකටිං එකෙන් ස්ලිම් එකෙන්. ඉතින් අපි බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා දැන් අපි පොඩි පොඩි පියවර ගත්තාම එක පැත්තකින් අපි ප්‍රාදේශීය මට්ටමින් අපි අදහසක් නැත්තම් යම් කිසි මේ පාරක් කපලා දෙන ගාම්ම අනිත් පැත්තෙන් අර පිටරට නැත්තම් විදේශීය වෙළඳපොළට යන්න අපි අඩිතාලමත් නැත්තම් ඒ යටිතල පහසුකමත් හදාගන්න බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා. ඉතින් දැන් මේව එකපාරට වෙන්නේ නැහැ. ඉතින් මේව අඩුම ගානේ අපි එක පියවරක් ගන්න. දැන් දැන් පියවර කරන් තියෙනවා. ඔව්. ඉතින් අපේ අපේ 1977 වෙනකලා
airports are different, dirty world airport,
පිළිගන්නවා. ඉතින් මෙහෙමයි, දැනට කලින් අපේ චේම්බර් එකේ නැත්නම් අපේ මණ්ඩලයේ IT සෙක්ෂන් එකකට නියෝජිතයක් තිබෙන්නේ නැහැ. ඉතින් අපි ගිය අවුරුද්ද ඉඳන් ආයන් 1 කියලා මම හිතන්නේ ඒගොල්ලන් ජාත්‍යන්තර මට්ටමේහුත් පිළි අරන් තියෙන ආයතනයක්. ඒගොල්ලන් දැන් අපි කැඳවලා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් ඒ හරහා අපේ තරුණ තරුණියන්ටත් ගම්මට්ටමෙනුත් අයි දැන් කවුරුත් යන්නේ කම්පියුටර් ප්‍රෝග්‍රෑමින් කෝස් එකටනේ. ඉතින් අපිට ඒ ආයන් 1 නැත්නම් අපේ මණ්ඩලය හරහා ඒගොල්ලන්ට කොහොමද පාර කපලා දෙන්නේ කියලා. මොකද ලේසිම දේ තමයි ඉන්ටෙලෙක්චුවල් ප්‍රොපර්ටි. දැන් ඒගොල්ලන්ට පුළුවන් නම් මොන හරි ප්‍රෝග්‍රෑමයක් හදලා ඒක අපනයනය කරන්න, මම හිතන්නේ අපිට සෑහෙන තැනක් තියෙනවා. ඉතින් මම මේ මිස්ටර් පී.ඩි. ෆර්නාන්ඩෝත් එක්ක කතා සාකච්ඡා කර කර හිටියේ, මම හිතේ අපේ මේ ටැලන්ට් වල ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැහැ. අපිට ඒ දැනුම තියෙනවා, අපිට අවශ්‍ය වෙන්නේ ධීරියයි යම්කිසි යන්න පාරක්. ඉතින් ඒ පාර කපලා දෙන්න තමයි අපි මේ මෙතන මැදිහත් වෙන්නේ. හරි, අනිත් එක තමයි මම අනිත් ටික කියවන්නම්. Point 3 again, the need to clarify as to how the trade policy will be integrated with the export policy. Then export policy ka tamai api then hadagena yanne EDB ekat ekka. In case of the investment policy, we clear guidelines and directions related to skills development. Oka tamai then maithana api saakatcha kare. To overcome the shortage of identified technical management skills, innovative mechanisms to finance investments and R&D activities. Then R&D වලට incentives තිබ්බට ඒක හරියට අරගෙන නැහැ. Then identification of new sectors with potential for development and integration into global value chains. Then අපිට end product එක විතරක් නෙමෙයි, අපි value chain එක යම්කිසි පුරුකයකට ගත්තා නම් ඒකත් එක්තරා export එකක්. Then clearly state the policy related to trade agreements including measures to overcome non-tariff barriers and measures to enter into mutual recognition agreements and measures to determine negative lists and need to establish a single authoritative source to obtain information. Then infrastructure එක මම හිතන්නේ වැදගත්. And in regard to trading services, the need to clearly state the policy covering mode 3. ඒ කියන්නේ the movement of professionals, right? And particularly on what basis professionals and technical personnel will be allowed into Sri Lanka related to investments in projects and mechanism to obtain time bound clearances for their numbers through the relevant Sri Lankan professional associations. ඒ කියන්නේ මම හිතන්නේ ඒක නම් හරිම වැදගත් කියලා. මොකද අපේ වෘත්තිකයන්ට තැනක් මේ තියෙන පද්ධතියේ තැනක් අහුරු කර ගන්න ඕනේ. Because what happens now is in a multinational, you will find a whole lot of expats coming and our people are not recognized. So I think that is something we have to take on very, very seriously. The policy to streamline trade procedures, removing unnecessary ones and simplification of others to ensure efficient and low-cost transactions. The method of internal barriers to අපි බලා ගන්න ඕනේ. අපිට ව්‍යවසායකයෙක් හැටියට, ව්‍යාපාරිකයෙක් හැටියට අපිට තියෙන බාධක මොකක්ද කියලා ඒවා අපි ඉස්සලා විසඳ ගන්න ඕනේ. කියන්නේ අපි ව්‍යාපාරයකට යන්න තියෙන පහසුකම, යටිතල පහසුකම් අපිට ලබලා දෙන්න ඕනේ. Then finally rationalization of institutional functions and institutions themselves including the number of ministries and their functions. ඒක මම හිතන්නේ මහත්තුරු මහත්මීන්ට බොහොම ඍජුව රෙකමෙන්ඩ් කරන්නත් පුළුවන්, කරන්න දෙයක් පුළුවන්. මොකද දැන් උදාහරණයක් ගත්තොත් ඉන්ඩස්ට්‍රීස්, දැන් ministry of industries and other portfolios ඒකට ගොනු කරලා තියෙනවා, ගොනු කරලා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් අර ෆෝකස් එකක් නැති වෙනවා. ඉතින් අපි කියන්නේ if we have certain areas that we want to develop in, let's be focus 100% on those developers, say trade, industry. But if you mix everything together, you will lose focus. So that is our case here. So we have made some recommendations through the other chambers also to see now with the cabinet reshuffle coming in, what we would recommend. So what has come out is that we would like to have a single minister for industries, so that you don't dilute that function. Now, personally, to say my background, I started my life as a quality controller at Luxapana Batteries. Now, we had the biggest challenge at that time, the joy to compete with Eveready, which was a multinational. And we competed very successfully in the early 80s. But today, Luxapana Batteries do not exist. We are importing the battery and jacketing it. Now, that is the sorry state of our manufacturing base. I come, though I'm in insurance now, I come from a chemical background. So my first 12 years in my career was in the industrial chemical field. But the industries and manufacturing is not done properly here. So I think that is the first step and the ease of getting into manufacture and probably joint ventures. So ladies and gentlemen, those are my points. I will welcome any questions or any clarification. Monari Prakasakaran and then Prasati Anand, Maria Uttara Denna Kamati. I'm sorry. No, point is, no. I can give it. I can give this way. I had no problem. But this is actually there is nothing new in this, right? This is the analysis of the report, but one view from a research company. That's all. So it is an internal document, but I thought it would be useful to bring it here. Yes, sir. The bullet sheet. Excuse me. That was a letter I will give you. No, I can share that with you.
This is the letter I wrote to the secretary of the police. So this elaborates the policy. So what happens last month? Was it price higher than they were? Is that why it went out of the?
No, what happened was people started importing batteries. And the industry shut, and of course the internal, I believe, I left that company a long time ago, but I believe that it was not managed properly. And they gave in to Eveready, but now even the Eveready, that Union Carbide, they also stopped manufacturing batteries because it was cheaper to import from India, from China. So now that is an industry I know about. So then you take the other industries. Now we have Shake Industries manufacturing soap. Today they are not there. They have been bought over. So what is the incentive we are giving our manufacturing out? Yeah, but again, those are all by multinationals. Lux is done by Unilever. Now Swadeshi is there. Swadeshi industry is there. So now, what are they doing? I mean, I'm sure in the local marketplace, they have a very small percentage. And they say they export. We are not too sure of the export statistics. But that is again a family-run company, which probably does not have enough professional help to sustain them. I'm only talking. I don't know the inside workings of it. They are exporting. Now these are the issues we have to raise. The ease of doing business. Now I remember I was doing chemical. I was the head of the chemical department at MacWoods a long time ago. Now we used to import liquid glucose to manufacture toffees here, or confectionery industry. Now when you import from the Benelux group of countries, they get a 50% rebate on the export. Now here, there is no incentive for that.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you for having me, and my pleasure.